So one of the key components of a charter is to actually build a unified integrated community, because that is really what we stand for. We want to make sure that all the components of our Hindu temple are sort of aligned with that. Because at no point do we want to ensure that we are dividing the community in any way. So if we build a temple, we want to make sure that stuff is placed well. Saratogans are very sensitive. So they do not want to increase the traffic. They do not want high structures that impede the visibility. I was in the city planning commission and I sort of understand how the thinking works. So we want to make sure that we don't portray ourselves as not considerate. I think that is very important. Then we also want to, and I think this is very important, to strengthen the spiritual and moral fabric of our society. Because religion is definitely a component, but it's more important for us to build a good moral fabric to our society. And that's one of the charters. And then the other component is to propagate meditation, yoga. These are gateways to spiritual growth and healthy living. And I think key components of what we are trying to do. And then some of the folks actually, they tell me that we can actually forego a Hindu temple, but what I would like to have is a community center. For them, a community center for Indians is very important. And I think we are sort of, that is also part of our charter. Perhaps we'll do one before the other, we don't know. Because if you look at the Survey Monkey feedback that we got, many of the people wanted to have a configuration to create a forum for us to celebrate our festivals, our occasions. And that was very important to them. But at the end of the day, we want to make sure that what we do is in alignment with our community. Because we don't want to do something one-off that our local community, which includes Saratoga, Purnima, West San Jose, Los Gatos, Montesorino, Campbell, these are essentially our local community. And we want to make sure that when we create something that is in alignment with what the community wants. And it's not just a question of a few members. We want to make sure that we address it all. So the Survey Monkey actually got us some good feedback. And welcome to Nipun Agarwal, who is one of the trustees of the temple, one of the founding members. Thank you for joining, and that's Neelam, Nipun's better half. And also, one of the things that we have started is the education. What we have rolled out is certain offerings that is available for free to Saratogans, and actually to the whole world. Anybody can come in and get the education. And I can't keep on it. So on Tuesday, you will see coverage by Saratoga News. Talked to the reporter last week, and they were very excited to see that this has been offered for all of Saratoga. So there will be an article that will cover all the different offerings that we currently have, and you'll see some of that. And the one key component that I would like to bring out is also the emphasis on purity and spirituality, because we have seen some of the religious institutes that go a little bit of a political route, and we are not there for that. We are there to really create a very safe container for spiritual growth of all members of the society. And it's not just for Indians, it's open for everyone. Everybody is welcome to come in. And just like how this church invited us to use this space as and when we need it, we would like to be also welcoming players in the community. We would like to make sure that everybody is welcome. And then last but not least, total and absolute transparency in our administration, because that is extremely important. That builds the brain trust. People kind of feel that, yes, these guys are doing the right thing. So let me talk a little bit about education. So there are four categories of our classes. And we divide it up. It's healthy living, we have language classes, understanding the ancient writings, and chantings for wellness. So for healthy living, wellness, via yoga, meditation, pranayama, we have meditation by Jyoti Bharadwaj, who is one of our teachers, and he has been leading that class. And then we also have a yoga teacher, who is Mani Gangu. She's been leading yoga. And we have Sangeeta Sampath sitting right here. Sangeeta leads the pranayama class. And how many classes do we have so far, Sangeeta?
Well, we've been... Hi, everyone. We've been having classes from the time we kicked off by end of May. So starting June, we've been meeting every week on Fridays. And I have Ms. Neeta here. She's a part of our class. So once I give my feedback, you know, I'll also request Ms. Geeta to tell a few words about what she feels. And we meet at one of our participants' home, and we have an hour's class every Friday between 6:30 and 7:30.
Excellent. Thank you.
Ms. Geeta, do you want to share a few words?
We'll get to that. Yeah. We'll get to that. We also have a few others. Let's see. We also have the wellness class. So that's my better half, Seema, joining in. So some of the other classes we have is the language class by Dr. Geeta Kankar, and she is a veteran Sanskrit teacher. She's taught Sanskrit in India for a very long time in various universities. So she is really kind teaching Sanskrit. We have Mrs. Meera Ramchandra, who is not joining me today, who is teaching Hindi. And what she does is she teaches at the library, the Saratoga library. She has 5 kids who are joining in to learn Hindi. We also have Mr. and Mrs. Pandey, a senior couple in Canton. And then we have the understanding the ancient writings and teachings. So we have a few teachers, and we are still evolving some of these programs. We have Manoj Joshi, who is not here, he just arrived. He's going to live 100 years. Manoj Joshi! Thank you for joining us. So that's Manoj Joshi, and we are still creating a program. Manoj, right here. Right, the chair is with your name on it. And then we also have, with Kumar Tabiniji, we are also formulating a class. And we are in the process of, we have his name listed on the website, but we do not have a class yet. And Vish is talking about creating a Vedanta class. And Vedanta, Vedanta, it's more like a satsang, actually. And we are still discussing that. It's not completely fine. And then we also have some chanting classes. We have Priya Pulavari, who does the shloka class, and Sangeeta Narasimhan, who is here. Sangeeta has been talking about doing a bhajan class. And then we have Kavita Prabhu, who is doing a bhajan class. So that, in a nutshell, is some of our offerings. Do we have Sriram? Yes, Sriram is here. Okay. So Sriram is the founder of the Sri Mahakaleshwar Mandir in Santa Clara. And very delighted to have Sriram join us. Sriram recently moved to Saratoga, is that right?
Yes.
So he's a member of our community, super excited. So Sriram's spiritual exploration started during 2003. He was initiated into the Dasa Mahavidyas by Pandit Sanjay Rath, a medical Vedic scholar, astrologer. And so Sriram has learned the Vedic astrology for several years from Sri P.V. Narasimha Rao, Sanskrit and Vedic scholar. And if you are familiar with the Sri Jagannatha Hora software, actually I have downloaded that piece of software a couple years back. That was created by Sri P.P. Narasimha Rao. 80% of the Vedic astrologers in the world actually use that. And Sriram has learned mantra and tantra sadhana from Swami Sadasivam, Tapasvi, and Sri Mahakali Upasaka from Chennai. So Swami Sadasivam had a vision. He was doing Bhasma Archana at Sri Mahakaleshwar Temple in Ujjain. And he was instructed to consecrate 12 Jyotirlingas in North America. And in the process, Sriram and Swami Sadasivam founded the first Jyotirlinga temple. And that is Sri Mahakaleshwar Temple in Santa Clara. So I would like to invite Sriram to come here and tell us a little bit about his reasons for founding the temple and his vision for what it takes for us to build a good temple here. We have a roadmap of 5 to 10 years, but we'd love to get some insight from Sriram. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you. Just moved in Saratoga a couple of months ago. It's about 5 years ago. Glad to be part of Saratoga here. Thank you, Rishi. And I guess, you know, I want to take very few minutes and just kind of share the whole process of how Mahakaleshwar came to existence. And some of the experiences I've had the last year and a half since we actually started. the initial objective is very simple, and nothing complicated. Ours. It was supposed to create a shrine or create spiritual energy so that people could come and perform sadhana, have practices, complete spiritual practices. Along with that, we wanted to make sure that people understood and were exposed to high level of spiritual exploration. Just to give an example, one of the teachers that we have, he has received, he has siddhis. He got siddhis when he was 17 years old. So just looking at you, everything that you've done so far, look at you and tell you what events have happened in your life, and just look at it. Now, the way he has done that, and the way he's achieved that, he has the blessings of the course. He has done a lot of para upasana. And there's something in the cosmos called Ritambara. That's where you can access any information, because everything that you do, even movement of your hand, gets recorded in the cosmos. And the layer of Ritambara, right, that he has accessed, so he can access it and tell you exactly, you know, what it is. And he's also a great astrologer, so he has a lot of correlations between these two as to why this red shirt or why the yellow belt, or what forces actually in the cosmos come together. So just a simple observation sometimes, but detailed observation that tells you the energies that come together, the confluence of the things to happen the way they do. So he, you know, he has been with many of the people, used to work for the anti-terrorist organization in India, because people used to come, the police used to come and ask him. He could tell exactly where people were located, what they were doing, where exactly things are. You know, we sometimes in English we call it psychic, that is beyond the psychic powers, it is made psychic powers. And he, and in fact a lot of all those times we have had in the temple, so talking about the experiences, although we had set it up simply as a spiritual shrine, it has turned out to be a lot more than we expected and experienced in the last year and a half or so. It's been a great center for a lot of people to come together. Every Sunday we have Nazi Seva, and we also have Music Seva in the temple. It's lovely to watch in front of the Nataraja people perform with great passion and great energy. That's one. And the second thing, it's touched and made a lot of difference in people's life. I did not know that. When people are in pain, they need some shoulder to lay their head on. And it's amazing to watch them come, just sit in the temple, just enjoying the vibration of the energy. And part of the process, mind you, is the purification. The Vedic Parayana that we do every day, the Vedic chants that we do, all we try to do is, you know, absolutely stay away from commercialism, no politics, absolutely. Just simple purpose is to create a shrine for great energy, a shrine for great purity. Also, I think, you know, as far as I was amazed, last Shivratri when we consecrated the temple, the Shivalinga, and brought it down, we were doing sadhana for it for about a year and a half before we brought it down. We were expecting maybe around 2,000 people. First 2 days, we had close to 9,000 people. And we had no idea how to make it. We had to prepare prasadam, we had to make the offering, we had to make the line. I needed volunteers. I had planned for about 30 or 35 volunteers who came just by the we had about 35 volunteers. But that day, I really needed about 90 volunteers. I could pick and choose anybody that came, and we came together with all those class. To me, when the streak of divinity comes in any of us, it's excellent to watch the sense of community and belonging come together. So all these things, I think, we, as Rishis rightly said, we invoke the right kind of energy, we invoke the right level of consciousness for us. Sometimes the sense of gratification, sometimes the fact that the divinity touches us makes us feel greatly gratified at the end of the day. All of us want to be told we are good and want to be good. There's no two ways in our life. Although all of us are, at the end of the day, just different colors of the same divine energy flowing towards us. Radiation of the different red and blue combination, which is yellow and blue combination of comfortable energy. So I think the objective is being pushing forward on it, making sure that we really bring the whole community together, bring a great source of energy for all of us to tap into, and learn the process of spirituality ourselves is a great idea. So thanks, Rishi. That's all I have to say. Good luck, and let's all work together.
Thank you, Sri Ram. It's really good to have your friendship.
Is at the intersection of Walsh Avenue and St. Thomas. This is hustle, you know, they are consecrated. It's got 1,170 guests, and it's about 6 foot lingam. And we also have Shakti, Shakti Pitam. We also do the Smahavi, we also do Aradha, Shakti also.
So, do you have a website?
Yes, it is. Sri Mahakal Mandir.org. Sri Mahakal Mandir.org.
So right now it's only one, right?
It's only one. We actually have another five lingams of the same size already finished. We are trying to start one in Boston, one in Paris, right on the next two temples that we're going to. Right. And also, I think the course of spiritual sadhana and talking about subjective relationships, a lot more intensified spiritual growth, and how even the mantra occurs and how the tantra occurs. That whole sadhana experience. So you can come, we'll teach you how the mantra can affect you and charge you. Just for example, a simple example, Kali, when a consciousness travels into Shiva. When you think of Shiva and purely passing and immerse yourself in Lord Shiva, it is the Shakti that calms you down tremendously. Because he, you know, you see here, he's in Nagendra, you have snakes running on, when you have Ganga, force of Ganges running on. You have so many different forces trying to disturb him, but he's in deep meditation. Nothing in the world steps to the point where he can't handle. So just Shivatattva, just going to the Shivatattva, and even chanting the Shiva Mantra with the Shivatattva. Similarly, for example, Rudra Shaktis, we have a lot of Rudra Shaktis, including the Mahavis. They needed energy to get up and go after what kind of Shakti do you need. All that is said, we've just begun to do a lot of research into that. Also, under the guidance of Mother Babu, who is, I told you, he's in English terms, he's a psychic, but he explains to you that he just logs into the Vedanta, he's a computer scientist, he's a computer biologist, like all of us. He says, when I need to, I log into the Vedanta and I can access the entire information in the cosmos. That's how he tells me this. And I said, so I am pursuing, you know, so for all of us, it's within our capacity and capability to reach that state. It's a matter of fact, it's taken over the rest of it. Thank you, I won't take too much time.
Thank you, Sri Ramdaru. Looking forward to chatting with you and really collaborating on this. This will be good. But, and thank you again for joining us. So what we'll do next is we have five amazing speakers who are ready with their insights. Insights for us on this occasion of Guru Purnima. But before we do that, we would like to run through a few shlokas from the Bhagavad Gita. And Janki Shukla, she understands Bhagavad Gita in and out. And I know that because she was deeply involved in actually reading the Bhagavad Gita for our peerless leader, Suzy Nagpa, who is no longer with us. I really appreciated Janki for doing that. And we always have high regard for our fearless leader, and we have high regard for Janki. So Janki, come on. She's going to read us a few verses from chapter 12, which is the heart of the Gita. And thank you, Janki, for joining us. And we have water, by the way, in that cooler there. So if you need water.
By memory, but I keep my book with me just in case I lose my consciousness, which I Arjuna Vacha Evam Satate Yuktaye Bhaktas Pampari Vasate Yecha Pyaksharam Avyaktam Tesham Ke Yoga Vittama Shri Bhagavan Vacha Maya Veshamano Yema Nitya Yuktaye Vasate Shraddhaya Paryopetas Teve Yuktata Mamata Yeta Vaksharam Nirdesham Avyaktam Paryupasate Sarvatra Kamachityam Cha Kutastam Achalam Duvam Sanyam Nindriya Ikramam Sarvatra Samabhutaya Te Prapuvanti Mameva Sarvabhutahite Ratha Tesho Nikataras Avyakta Sakta Chetasam Avyakta Hikatir Tukham Deha Vadhira Vapyate Yetu Sarvani Karmani Mai Sanyasya Matpara Ananye Naiva Yogena Mam Jayanta Upasate Tesham Aham Samurtata Vrithya Samsara Sagara Bhavami Nachirat Partha Maya Veshaka Chetasam Mai Deva Mana Adatsva Mai Buddhim Niveshaya Nivashishyasi Mai Deva Ata Urvam Na Sanshaya Ata Chittam Samadatam Na Satnoshi Mai Stiram Abhyasa Yogena Tato Mami Chatum Dhanam Jaya Abhyaseka Samartosi Matkarma Parmo Bhava Madartam api karmani kurvan siddhina vapsyasi Ate tadakme shaktosi kartam